Hello, this is Galen Martling. I am here today showing watercolor using ink pads, and I am featuring Unity Stamp Company stamps. One is called Beautiful Unicorn, and the background is a faithful letter. And this is a beautiful, beautiful unicorn. I couldn't wait to get this one, and I haven't inked it up yet, so I am going to try watercolor on watercolor paper. And instead of watercolor inks, I'm going to use dye ink pads. In this case, I'm using premium dye ink pads by My Favorite Things. But first, I'm stamping with their Extreme Black Hybrid Ink Pad. It is alcohol ink friendly and watercolor friendly. So I am using the smooth side of a watercolor sheet of paper by Ranger. I like their watercolor paper. I am choosing to stamp on the smooth side. It's just easier to get a better impression. I stamped it two or three times using the original Misty, and then I heat set all that ink. And I just stamped everything in black because I know I'm going to add a lot of color. I am choosing very bright colors for this because it's a unicorn, and I have a vision of just really a lot of bright colors. So I am choosing very bright colors. I have four ink pads. I am dabbing them directly onto a large acrylic block. And then I add some water. First, I add water to the watercolor paper. And then I dip the color into the paint and then dip it back into that blotch of color of water. And then I do the same with this pinkish color. I do it the same with the blue, and then I come in with extra water each time and move that color around. You can use an ink smooshing technique and just add the water to the acrylic block and then put that background right over it. This time I just decided to go ahead and use my brush to get sections of color, and then I add even more water to that paper to blend those colors together and let them move and blend where they want by just adding water. And so I decided not to dilute it too much. I wanted that color to be very bright. But if you wanted a muted color, you just put less color down onto that paper and use more water to move it around. And it will get a little lighter. Also, it will dry a little bit lighter. Watercolor does that. Now, I have a very fine brush that I am using to watercolor using that same leftover color that's on that palette there. I'm using a fine tip brush to color in those tiny flowers and the mane and the horse. So now I am just using almost all of the colors. I just want to get colors to match the background. And so I concentrated that red a little deeper for those roses. Then I added some blue and yellow, and I am allowing the brush to go into the red and the yellow to just try to get maybe a little bit of an orange look, sort of a salmon-y look there into the mane. I don't want it to be solid, so I am just adding all of those colors all throughout that top of the horse there. It could be any way you want. This is just how I envision it. Oh, very colorful card. And so for the horse, I didn't have brown in any of the inks that were dye ink. So I went ahead and used a little bit of Prima watercolor brown ink for the horse. And I'll show you in a minute here. And these are, the Primas were from tubes of watercolor, and they dry solid, so adding a little bit of water to it, you get a chance to move it around. But that particular color of brown had a lot of red in it, so it wasn't what I was thinking it was going to be when I added it to the horse. And so I go ahead and add a lot of water and move that color that I already put down, but it's not ruined. You can remove shade by making your brush damp with a paper towel and moving it over that color to lighten it. I just wanted a more of a beigey look instead of a red for the mane horse. So then add a little water to move that around and then dampen your brush blot it with a paper towel, and just move what you like. Now to remove even more blotchiness, I go ahead and to soften the look a little bit more, I add a dry paper towel over each of those panels, the background panel and the horse panel, to make it just softer looking, a little bit more natural. All of the color still is there. The color will stain the paper too, so it's still there. It's just not large puddles of it. It helps it to dry faster as well. And so then I fussy cut this unicorn, which is just cutting it out with scissors. And I want to place that right over that background panel. I use a Copic marker in black just to go around the edges of where I fussy cut. It helps it stand out a little bit more, the stamping. And so I layer that background panel. Once it's all dry, I heat set everything to make sure it was real dry. And then I add that with foam tape, all of the layers, and it's so pretty. The only extra thing I did was add some twine to the top of this card. I hope you like this and give it a try. Thanks a lot for watching and taking the time today. I hope you take a minute to subscribe to my channel. Have a great day.